Hi, this is Peter Chisholm. Once again, WACA-TV is proud to bring you a show from the Hat Shell in Boston as Boston celebrates the 4th of July with a Boston Pops concert and fireworks show at the Hat Shell on Sturrow Drive. Today, we're looking forward to having the Pops play their songs, including the famous Stars and Stripes Forever. And also, this year, they'll be accompanied by the U.S. Army Field Band and Chorus and the great some other great musical entertainer. Entertainment this evening. They've got four singers that have been brought in, including Melissa Etheridge, who's been world-renowned as a country rock singer, and we hope you enjoy the show. Gabby, who's going to be here tonight. Have you been here before, the concert and fireworks?
No.
Oh, you must. Are you really looking forward to it?
Yes.
Where are you from?
Wisconsin.
Oh, Wisconsin? Whereabouts? Whereabouts in Wisconsin? I've been out there. I've been to Green Bay.
Near the Twin Cities.
Oh, yeah?
Yeah.
I was out there. Green Bay and the place where they used to brew old-style beer.
Oh, Milwaukee.
La Crosse.
Oh, La Crosse? Yeah, yeah, we're not far from there.
Yeah, yeah, in Green Bay. So you must be, this is going to be quite a night then, you know? You know they fire cannons though near the end of the evening. And they get pretty loud, so make sure you may want to hold your ears. They fire 16 of them. But it's a lot of fun. You know, I mean, the church bells ring then and whatever. Then the last song of the night, they play the Stars and Stripes Forever. And here's a tip, just watch the back of the stage during that song, okay? And it's a big surprise near the end.
Okay.
You'll see it, yeah? You'll see it.
He's excited. Who do you want to see perform? Who's performing your songs tonight?
Andy Grammer.
Andy Grammer, yeah. We came last night to the rehearsal, and he did a great job. You know, I'm glad you look forward to seeing him.
Yep, I do.
That's good. And you know who else is going to be here tonight? The U.S. Army Field Band and Chorus.
Ooh.
And I give them a plug because I was in the Army a long time ago.
Yeah.
You know, but we hope you enjoy your show.
Yeah, we will. Thank you much.
Yep. How long are you in Boston for?
Till Friday.
Till Friday. That's good. I'll enjoy your visit.
Yeah, thank you much. Appreciate
it. Hi, I'm here with the battery commander, Captain Jenkins, from the 101st Field Artillery out of Danvers, Massachusetts. And you guys have a pretty important role here this evening.
We do. We get to play with the Boston Pops and do our part of the 1812 Overture.
And I guess I'd say you guys play the drums, but your cannons are a lot louder than the drums.
Yeah, it's kind of like the drums and the cowbell and everything all just thrown into one.
It is. That's true. They, I noticed that we were here last night for the rehearsal,
mm-hmm.
and the audience really, they look forward to the part of the song, the music, when the cannons go off there. You know, they the church bells start ringing. They start cheering and all.
Yeah, the public seems to really enjoy this opportunity to see their military in action and get a little chance to interact with us.
That's really good. And they want to point out that Captain Jenkins here has been deployed before, like so many members of our National Guard now from Massachusetts. And we're glad you're home safe, and thank you for taking a couple minutes to talk with us today.
No problem.
Okay.
Thank you for your support.
Yep. Hi, I'm here with Paul and his family here from Woburn, Mass. And we just want to ask you, have you been here before for the show?
One time. Last year when Demi Lovato and Nick Jonas was here. That was my first time. I came here blind, and it was awesome, so I'm here again.
Well, I'm glad you liked it. I know we came last night for the rehearsal, and I know you told me you're a veteran.
Yes.
So tonight we're going to have the U.S. Army Field Band here in Chorus.
Yeah, I will definitely remember all the songs. Maybe I'll sing along.
I'm sure you will. And, of course, the fireworks by Grucci. I'm sure that your daughter's going to love seeing the fireworks.
Oh, yeah. She will. This is her first time coming.
Oh, yeah?
So she'll love it. Yeah, it's good.
It's good.
Before it was just me and her, so.
Yeah.
It should be fun. I love it. It's a great event. And anyone who hasn't tried it definitely should come.
Now, you mentioned you were stationed in Germany.
Yes.
Where were you in Germany?
Wielsteck, Germany.
What's that near?
40 minutes to Nuremberg.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah.
Very good. I was up in Nuremberg before, but I was down in Munich. How'd you enjoy it over there?
Oh, yeah. When I had time off, I loved it. It was like a vacation.
Oh, well, good. We want to thank you for taking time to talk with us.
Yeah, no problem. Thank you.
Show.
I will.
Okay,
you too.
Thanks. Yep, thank you. I'm here with Jane from Atkins, Texas. But Jane has lived in Massachusetts for a good number of years.
Yep.
She moved away, but she knows when to come back home.
That's right. Home for my granddaughter's graduation and the Pops with Keith Lockhart.
That's good. And this year, I don't know if you know, but they're going to be having some excellent entertainers. The star of Hamilton and...
I saw that. That's great.
Melissa Etheridge, it's very, very good.
It's always excellent.
It is.
I love it.
Yep. We were here last night for the rehearsal, and the crowd loved it.
You know? I almost came down, but I figured one day's enough.
Well, you got yourself a nice spot here, too.
Yeah.
You know, yeah.
Very patriotic spot.
Yeah. Great viewing, you know, angle, too. Look right at it. Yep.
If they take the tents down, I hope they do.
Yeah, they do. They have to take the tents down. Yeah.
That's great.
And it starts at 8 o'clock.
Hi, I'm Captain Jenkins. I'm here with Charlie Battery 101st Field Artillery. I'm here to explain the 101 howitzers here. So this is our ceremonial howitzer. We use it for the 1812 Overture. It's a 105mm howitzer. They're built in the 50s. We just use them now for ceremonial purposes. So how it works, very simple. Just take your blank cartridge. This one's obviously spent. You can insert it right here in the chamber. Just close the breech. Firing lanyard right here. So we fired 19 of those for the 1812 Overture, and that's about all she wrote.
Hi, I'm here with Linda and her family here to watch the concert tonight.
Oh, absolutely.
Where are you from, Linda?
I am from South Carolina.
South Carolina. Have you been here before for the concert?
No. This is on my bucket list. That's why I'm here.
Well, you've got a good night to come. We've got some great entertainment tonight.
I'm looking forward to it.
Yeah, Melissa Etheridge, a gentleman named Kramer. We have a Kramer, I mean. We have the star of Hamilton, and we have the U.S. Army Field Band and Chorus. So it should be really good.
Absolutely fabulous.
And of course, we have the fireworks.
Oh, yes, we're definitely here for the fireworks.
And you're familiar with the one of the songs tonight. Near the end, they start firing cannons, the church bells, and there'll be 16 cannon shots.
Wow, won't that be fun?
They have some howitzers down there, parked on the grass next to the hat shell.
Right.
And there's an artillery company from the Massachusetts National Guard.
That sounds wonderful.
Them. And then during the Stars and Stripes Forever, near the end, there's a special surprise in the back of the hat shell.
You see it
there.
Oh, great.
Yeah.
We'll be looking forward to that.
You'll see, you know?
That sounds wonderful.
You've got great seats here to watch.
Yes, we do. Yeah. And we've been sitting here all day. We won't get up.
Yeah.
Not even to go to the bathroom. That's how much we love these seats.
That's nice. We're about to South Carolina.
Columbia.
Yes. That's the capital.
Right in the center of the state. Yes.
I've never been to South Carolina, but I've been to North Carolina. I was in Durham once when I was a child, and then later I went to what's the big city that right near the Smoky Mountains in North Carolina?
Can't remember. Asheville.
Asheville.
Yeah.
I went there. I had moonshine there.
Oh, wonderful!
Yeah, I took a little.
We got some moonshine in Columbia.
Oh, yeah.
Come on down.
Oh God, I swallowed a little right to my toes. I go, my God, I'll stick with beer. You know.
Yeah, it'll ring your bell if you're not careful.
Yeah, we should pick a great night to come. This is going to be the weather's perfect tonight.
Perfect, it is.
Not too hot or humid, no rain.
Yes.
So enjoy the concert and the fireworks.
Thank you.
And one tip though, when the concert's over, the fireworks, when they start, are over there, and there are a lot of trees in the way. So you're trying to make your way over there as best you can, or, you know, whatever you can find open.
It's hard to move around here.
Yeah. Yeah, well, you know, it's interesting. The crowd right now is far below what it usually is.
Really?
I don't know why, I mean, there's so much room out there in the grass.
Wow, maybe we're in love tonight.
Yeah, by this time of the day, you know, everything's taken.
Really?
Yeah. Yeah, it's really unusual this year. I don't know, maybe it'll pick up in the next 3 hours.
Three hours.
We do.
But look, we're glad you're here and enjoy the concert.
And we certainly will. Thank you very much.
Take care.
Oh my God, what a thrill to be.
Good evening, ladies and gentlemen. We're about to start a great event, the Boston Pops 4th of July Fireworks Spectacular. We have an incredible show planned today, and I'm joined by some of the fabulous artists you will see on stage, accompanied by your own Boston Pops tonight. I'm going to introduce them all, and then we'll take a few questions, and then we're all going to go get ready to do this thing. Let me see. Starting from my left over here, we have Broadway's last leading man, as he was once referred to, this is Mr. Brian Stokes Mitchell. Brian is here to sing the world premiere of a new patriotic song called The Sum of Us, written by one of America's most beloved composers. Ladies and gentlemen, the composer of such iconic musicals as Beauty and the Beast and The Little Mermaid, please welcome Alan Menken. Directly behind me, thus making it hard to do this, we have iconic rocker Melissa Etheridge. We have multi-platinum award winner, Andy Grammer. Honey, I'm good. And we have the Tony Award-winning star of the mega smash hit Broadway musical Hamilton, Mr. Leslie Odom Jr. Did I miss anybody back there? So we're all here to take your questions in the next couple of minutes, so please have at it. Didn't I sound excited about it already?
I want one more bite.
There are a lot of things that make this year special. One of them is that this is a great chance. This concert always is, but this particular year, when there's so much fraction and division in this country, this is a great chance for us to get together, celebrate what we have in common, our gratitude for this country, our hopes for its future. Personally, I love this year because the Pops has really become fully invested in running a show that's been a huge part of our lives for almost half a century now. I believe that this sort of a lineup is just absolutely perfect for this, the best celebration of America in the broadest possible scope. We play to the widest audience of any orchestra on this particular day. People from all walks of life, people of all ages, and I believe that this is a lineup that is celebratory and it's profound and it says exactly what I would like this concert to say. And I managed to kill all the other questions. Would any of you like to ask anything of our guest artists?
Absolutely.
Okay, well, pick one.
Begging works. I begged to come back and they said yes. That was my very first concert with an orchestra, and so it's a very rare thing. The cost of that is so prohibitive to most artists today, so any chance you get to sing with an orchestra, you learn so much, and you know, you're never supported like that. It's a dream come true, really. Yeah, it's, you know, art on the pavement. It's like I think most of the people behind me would be doing this even if we weren't getting a check. You know, we'd be street artists, you know, we'd be drawing your caricatures. I mean, this is what we love to do. So, especially Alan.
You're getting a check?
Yeah,
most of us have done that.
That's right. So it's just, you know, anytime you get to check in that way with the people, it's a really wonderful thing, and it you touch your roots in that way. It's a wonderful thing.
We're meant for each other. It's really, it's a sweet thing. You know, we got here yesterday and you see a whole orchestra chart for a song that you wrote. That's very special. That doesn't happen very often. So I'm very, very excited to be here. When pop meets the pops, it's really, really good stuff.
And I know you're from California.
Yes.
But to be here in Boston on a 4th of July,
I can't think of a more patriotic city than Boston. We were in the trailer back on, like, is there one? I don't think there is. So to be here doing this in this city, it's about as good as it gets.
Talk about the idea behind making Keep Your Head Up acoustic, because I know that's a very upbeat song and you're a very upbeat person. So why did you make Keep Your Head Up
acoustic? Keep Your Head Up acoustic?
Yeah.
It's really sweet to go from just a guy and a guitar to a freaking full orchestra. There's something special about that. So that's kind of why we did it. Awesome. Thanks so much.
I'm short.
When we talked to you last time that you were here with the Pops, I literally got goosebumps from that experience. How does it feel to be back here with them after a few years?
The Boston Pops are, I mean, as everyone's been saying, it's a national treasure. And Keith, and what you do with the Pops, and how closely they work with popular music. I love that it's just that intersection between pop and rock even. I mean, they're rocking out up there with me. And it's such a delight. And I spent 1979, 1980 living in Boston. And so I am aware of every July 4th what this is, and I just could not be more delighted and honored to be part of it.
And I know that there'll be plenty of fans out here to see tonight. What do you want to say to people who are coming out here and spending hours waiting for the show?
I want to say, let yourself be inspired. Look around at how many people are here, and then look around at how different they all are, and what a beautiful city this is, and what a beautiful neighborhood and community it is of people celebrating our nation's birthday, and how patriotism looks, because this is what it is. It's families of all shapes and sizes and colors and beliefs, and it's a beautiful way to really see that. It's just looking, the view I have from the stage is life-changing, so I hope that everyone can be inspired by that today. Thank you.
Oh, I'm sorry.
The Little Mermaid movies are my all-time favorite.
Thank you.
Movies of all time. Will we be hearing any of that tonight, or what are we going to be hearing?
No, we have a new song that Keith had gotten in touch with me a few months ago. He said, but I want to write a new patriotic song to perform, which is, it's an irresistible commission, and to be done with the Boston Pops is just incredible.
I have to tell you, what a great guy this is. We've met once before. The second time was when I walked out this door here and didn't recognize him when I walked by him. We met together on the stage for the world premiere of Disney Musical's 25th anniversary
celebration
in Royal Albert Hall. He made a cameo appearance, just an amazing cameo appearance, and I was stuck up on the podium leading the orchestra during that time. And we met very briefly after that, and when one of my staff said, wouldn't it be great if someone like Alan Menken would write a new song for this event? I said, well, I've got his email because I think he said a thank you, so I'll ask him, and here we are.
Yeah, it was great. And I asked my Newsies collaborator, Jack Philbin, to collaborate with me on this one called Some of Us, which is about diversity, and I can't wait to hear it. I cannot wait.
It's instrumental, or is there a lyric?
Oh, there's a lyric. Yeah, there's a lyric, and Brian Stokes Mitchell will be singing it.
Lucky guy.
Brian, well, how does it feel to you, not to get political, but in such divisive times, to be singing a new patriotic song on this 4th of July?
It feels like it's exactly the salve that we need as a country right now. I think we sometimes forget, with all the craziness that we see on the news and everything, you think, oh, how could this possibly get worse? I think what happens is we look at what's happening in Washington, D.C., and we think it's the country. It's not the country, and we have to remember the people in Washington, D.C. work for us, not the other way around. And we have to remember that it's America's of, for, and by the people. And a celebration like this, here by the beautiful Charles River, like Melissa was saying, looking out in an audience of all of these disparate colors, beliefs, religions, everybody sitting together celebrating this country on this day is a really wonderful inspiration, I think, for all of us. And it gives me lots of hope. It's really about hope for the future, I think. That's what this concert really leaves me with, that good feeling. You know what, I'm in Boston all the time. I was here shooting a pilot about 2 months ago. I've done, I don't know how many concerts with the Boston Pops now, probably 6, 7, 8, 9, I don't know.
Last time we opened the EMK Institute together.
Yeah.
I guess that was probably the last time.
I think that maybe was, yeah.
But, freezing in the snow in April. Right?
Yes, yeah, it feels like home here. I love this orchestra, I love this town. This is my very first time to sing here in the pavilion, so I'm really, really excited about doing this for so many people that have just shown up and have waited for hours to be here.
You guys are great to be here. I'm going to let our guest artists have a little bit of space before they have to go on and do this. Thank you very much. Happy 4th of July, everyone.
I want to take a moment here to thank both Bloomberg and Ethan Vance for stepping up. Last year, many of you might recall, after the last concert, CBS moved out and David Mugar kind of retired from producing and the show and the concert. And we want Bloomberg and Ethan Vance stepped in to fill that void and to provide the continuance of this great tradition in the city of Boston. We want to thank both of them this evening for doing that.
Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome members of the Concert Band and Soldiers Chorus of the U.S. Army Field Band under the direction of Colonel Jim Keane, Commander, and Tony Award-winning performer Brian Stokes Mitchell.
Oh,
for spacious skies, for your amber waves of grain, for purple mountain majesty above the fruited plain. America, America, God shed his grace on thee and crown thy good with brother and sister. From sea to shine, sea. I see his face. Look in those eyes, how wise they seem. Well, when he is old enough, I will show him America, and he will ride on the wheels of a dream.
Ready to shine. the Boston Pops, under the direction of conductor Keith Lockhart with the Star Spangled Banner.
Band and Soldiers Chorus of the U.S. Army Field Band in saluting our nation's armed forces. And we ask you, if you have served your country in that capacity, please stand when you hear your service song so we can show our appreciation.
Thank you.
The Soldiers Chorus and the Boston Pops performing This Is My Country. The score of the film The Patriot is one of John Williams' most stirring. That says a great deal, since this man is responsible for so many memorable musical moments. It's included in our new album, celebrating John's 85th birthday. Joining us this evening for The Patriot are the Middlesex County Volunteers, Fifes, and Drums. Enjoy.
Thank you. nothing says happy birthday, America, like an obsessive love song. So let's get going. Here we go. I know you're home. You left your light on. You know I'm here. The night is thin, yeah. I know you're alone. I watch the car leave. Your lover is gone. Let me open your back door. I just need to touch you once more.
Yes.
sing this one, and I want you to sing it back at me as loud as you possibly get. A little warm-up. Fouls go. You gotta keep your head up. Yeah, super loud. Here we go. I say, whoa, yeah. Hey, 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 hey. Whoa, no, no. Let me stop. I've been waiting on the sunset, builds on my mindset. I can't deny it, getting higher than my income breadcrumb. I've been trying to survive. The glow that the sun gets right around sunset helps me to realize this is just a journey. Drop your worries, you're gonna turn out fine. Whoa, you turn out fine. Let me hear you, Boston. Here it comes. I said, fine. Whoa, you turn out fine. But you gotta keep your head up. Oh, oh, you can let your head down. Eh, eh. You gotta keep your head up. Oh, oh, you can let your head down. Eh, eh. See, now I'm sorry. No, it's hard to remember sometimes. You gotta keep your head up. Oh, oh, you can let your head down. Eh, eh, eh. I got my hands in my pockets, kicking these rocks. It's kinda hard to watch this life go by. I'm buying into skeptics. Skeptics mess with the confidence in my eyes. Seeing all the angles, thoughts get tangled. I start to compromise. My life and my purpose, is it all worth it? Am I gonna turn out fine? Whoa, you turn out fine, yeah. I said fine. Whoa, you turn out fine. But you gotta keep your head up. Oh, oh, you can let your head down. Hey, hey, you gotta keep your head up. Hey, hey, now I'm sorry. No, it's hard to remember sometimes. You gotta keep your head up. Oh, oh, let your head down. Hey, 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 now only rainbows after rain. The sun will always come again. It's a circle, circling again. Come go down again. I said only rainbows after rain. The sun will always come again. It's a circle, circling. Last time, I want to get like obnoxious loud about this. If you could possibly do that, let me. Yeah. Everybody around the lake, let me hear you. But you gotta keep your head up. You can let your head down. So you gotta keep your head up. You can let your head down. Hey, hey, see, now I know it's hard. I know it's hard to remember sometimes. You gotta keep your head up. Oh, let your head down, hey, now keep your head up. You can let your head down, keep your head up. You can let your head down, keep your head up. You can let your head down. I'm singing, oh, la 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 la, yeah. Thank you so much. I'll see you in a little bit.
Keeping up at home while my husband is away. He's on the British side of Georgia. He's trying to keep the colonies in line. But he can keep all the Georgia. Doja, she mine. Love doesn't discriminate between the sinners and the saints. It takes, it takes, it takes. We keep loving anyway. We laugh, we cry, we break, we make mistakes. And if there's a reason, I'm still alive. Love's sweet as died, I'm willing to wait for it. I'm willing to wait for it. Grandfather was a fire, a brimstone preacher, preacher. There are things that I believe in him, so teacher, teacher. My mother was a genius, my father commanded respect, respect. When they died, they left no instructions, just a legacy to protect. Death doesn't discriminate between the sinners and the saints. It takes, it takes, it takes. And we keep living anyway. We rise, we fall, we break, we make mistakes. And if there's a reason, I'm still alive with him. Love, she had died. I'm willing to wait for it. I'm willing to wait for it.
I am the one thing in life I can control.
Hamilton doesn't hesitate. He exhibits no restraint. He takes and he takes and he takes and he keeps winning anyway. Changes the game, plays and he raises the stakes. And if there's a reason he seemed to thrive, so you survive. And God damn it, I'm willing to wait for it. I'm willing to wait for it.
I may have made one lyric flub. Don't tell anyone. That's just between us. Boston, thank you so much for having us. Okay, so I know there's a few Hamilton fans out there, but are there any just theater fans, just straight up theater fans out there? Boston! It's my town, I love you guys. The show that brought me to the theater, there was a show that was my Hamilton, and that show was called Rent. Okay, you know what, this song is from that show. Beats.
long night there, and these long, long legs, they're everywhere. Hold up, now you look good, I will not lie, but if you ask where I'm staying tonight, I gotta be like, oh baby, oh baby, you got me all wrong.
Sure.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you.